jumped our class. In our previous class, in our first chapter, that means in our first chapter is knowing our numbers. In our first chapter, in exercise 1.5, we have completed 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 5 problems has completed. Now, today, 6th problem. 6th question is, the total weight of a box of 5 biscuit packets of same size is 8 kg 400 grams. What is the weight of each packet? Have you understood the question? That means the total weight of a box of 5 biscuit packets. That means in a box, for example, it is a box. In this box, there are 5 biscuit packets like this. It is 1, it is 2, it is 3, like that. 5 biscuit packets are there. Then the total weight of this box is 8 kg 400 grams. 8 kg 400 grams. Now they are asking, what is the weight of each packet? That means they are asking now, the total weight of this box is 8 kg. Then they are asking, what is the weight of each biscuit packet? Then that means, what is the weight of one each biscuit packet? They are asking. Now we have to find what is the weight of each biscuit packet. Now question has completed. Now after question, leave one finger gap and start the solution. The total weight of box of 5 biscuit packets is, the total weight of a box of 5 biscuit packets is 8 kg 400 grams. 8 kg 400 grams. Now we have to find what is the weight of each packet. The weight of each biscuit packet is 8 kg 400 grams divided by 5. We have to do division with 5. Okay, how to find the solution now? 8 kg 400 grams. 1 kg is equal to how many grams? Then we will convert that are in kgs and grams. Now we will convert either grams into, if we have like this, if kgs and grams, either we have to convert grams into kilograms or kilograms into grams. Now we will convert grams into kilograms. So 1 kg is equal to how many grams? Then 1 kg is equal to 1000 grams. So 1 kg is equal to 1000 grams. Now I will convert grams into kilograms. So 8 kg means 8000 grams. So 8 kg 400 grams. That means 8 kg means 1 kg means 1000, then 8 kg means 8000 grams. 8000 grams plus 400 grams, that is total 8400 grams. Now we will do division. 8400 divided by 5. 8400 grams. That is equal to 8000 grams plus 400 grams. That is total. Both are in grams only. That's why we have to do addition. That is 8400 grams. 8400 divided by 5. Same like this. 8 kg 400 grams, it becomes 8400 total in grams only, divided by 5. Now do division. 8400. 5 ones are 5. 8 minus 5 is 3. 4. 5 6 are 30. Minus, here we have 4. Division is not sufficient here, we will do 50. Here we do 8400. 5 ones are 5, 8 minus 5 is 3, 4 becomes here, 5 6 are 30, because 5 7 35 will become greater number. Again minus, 4 minus 0 is 4, 3 minus 3 is 0, no need to write, here 0, 5 8s are 40, Next here we have 0. 5 zeros are 0. 0 minus 0, 0. So the weight of each biscuit packet is 1680 grams. The weight of each biscuit packet is hence the weight of each packet is 1680 grams. Have you understood? If we have grams or kilograms, then we have to convert either grams into kilograms, kilograms into grams, no problem. Here simply we have 1 kg is equal to 1000 grams. So 8 kg is equal to 8000. It is in grams only, it is in grams only. If we have both are same in quantity, then you have to add them. 8000 plus 400 gives 8400. Then you have to do division. If you do division, then you will get 8400 divided by 5 gives 1680. That means the weight of one biscuit packet is 1680 grams. Next, seventh question. The distance between the school and the bus stop is 1 kilometer 875 meters. Every day, Gayatri walks both the ways to attend the school. Find the total distance she walked in 6 days. She walked in 6 days. That means the distance between the school and the bus stop is 1 kilometer 875 meters. That means the distance between the school to bus stop. Here it is our school. From our school to our bus stop, the distance is simply 1 kilometer 875 meters. If it is like that, then Gayatri walks both ways to attend the school. Then both means twice. Gayatri is walking twice a day. Twice in a day. That means in one day she is walking twice. That means while you are going to school, while coming from school, she is walking daily twice. Then Gayatri walks both the ways. Both means two times Anna. While going to school, she is walking 1 kilometer 875 meters. While coming from school, she is walking again 1 kilometer 875 meters. Then attend the school. Find the total distance she walked in 6 days. That means daily she is walking two times. Like that. If she walks daily two times, then in 6 days, how much distance she will walk? They are asking. Now we have to find the distance for 6 days. So solution. The distance between the school and the college is the distance between the school and college. School and bus stop. Is 1 kilometer 875 meters. So now every day Gayatri walks both means two times. That means this 1 kilometer 875 meters she is walking two times in a day. So 1 kilometer 875 meters plus 1 kilometer 875 meters. So Gayatri walks twice in a day. That is 1 kilometer 875 meters plus 1 kilometer 875 meters. While she is going morning, it is while coming from school evening. Now 1 kilometer 875 meters plus 1 kilometer 875 meters. It gives. Now we will do addition. 1 kilometer. Now kilometers should be kilometers, meters should be meters. Already we have class 5 we have learned. 1 kilometer 875 meters. It is also again 1 kilometer 875 meters. Now do addition. 5 plus 5, 0, 1 here. 7 plus 7, 14. 14 plus 1, 15. 5 here, 1 becomes carry. 8 plus 8, 16. 16 plus 1, 17. 1 here, now 3. That means daily she is walking 3 kilometers, 750 meters. That is 3 kilometers, 750 meters. Now they are asking, find the distance she walked in 6 days. If she walks daily 3 kilometers 750 meters, then how much then she can walk in 6 days. Then the total distance.
Now the solution is
cloth required to stitch, cloth required to stitch uniform for each boy is one meter 80 centimeters. Now we'll convert these meters into centimeters. How to convert, Nana? Already we know 1 meter is equal to 100 centimeters. 1 meter is equal to 100 centimeters. That means here also they are same. Here 1 meter means here 100 centimeters plus 80 centimeters. Total it gives 100 plus 80, 180 centimeters, Nana. Both are in same, centimeters and centimeters. If you have both the same quantities, then you have to add it. Now, tailor stitch using 40 meters cap. Now, the tailor has 40 meters of cap. Tailor has 40 meters of cap. So, this 40 is in meters. We will convert this 40 is also into centimeters. So, same like 1 meter is equal to 40 centimeters. Now 40 meters means 4000. So 40 meters, that is equal to 40 into, we have to multiply with 100 because 1 meter is 100 centimeters. So 40 meters means 40 into 100. It gives 4000 centimeters. Now see, it is in centimeters, it is in centimeters. That means to stitch the uniform for one boy, they need 180 centimeters clap. Now the tailor has 400 centimeters clap. Then how many uniforms he can stitch and how much clad will left? Now we'll find how to find by doing division. That means tailor stitch using 40 centimeters clad. Tailor can stitch is now 4000 divides by 180. It is in centimeters, it is in centimeters. So you can do division, no problem. 4000 divides by 180. Now we will do division here. 180 divided by 4000. 18 ones are 18, 18 twos are 36. 180 ones are 180, 180 twos are 360. Simply you have to increase the 0. Now do subtraction. 0 minus 0, 0. Here if you take borrow, 10 minus 6 it becomes 4. Here 4 becomes 3. 3 minus 3 is 0. Note it. Again here we have 0. Come now. 400 means again 22. 182 is 360. 0. If you take borrow, 10 minus 6 is 4. It becomes 3. Note it. Now tailor can stitch 22 shirts and 40 meters cloth will left. Okay. Now the tailor can stitch, now we will write here, tailor can stitch 22 shirts and 40 centimeters cloth will left. Okay, that's it. If you have meters or centimeters, grams or kilograms, either you have to convert grams into kilograms or kilograms into grams. That means like this. Both are should be in same quantity. If you have same like that, then you can find the solution easily. Now, 8th one has completed. Now, 9th question. Now, 9th question is, the cost of petrol is ₹60 per liter. A petrol bunk sells 750 liters of petrol on a day. How much money do they get? Get at the end of the day. Ninth question is, the cost of petrol is ₹60 per liter. A petrol bunk sells 750 liters of petrol on a day. How much money did they get at the end of the day? Solution. Now they are asking, for 1 liter of petrol it is ₹60. If they sell daily ₹750 of petrol, then how much money they will earn daily? End of the day means up to night, evening. Now, the cost of 1 liter of petrol is ₹60. Then the cost of 750, see both are in liters only, so no need to convert. The cost of 750 liters of petrol is, for 1 liter ₹60, for 1 liter it is ₹60 into 750. Otherwise 750 into 1, for 750 liters how much is 750 into, for 1 liter ₹60, so 60 multiply them, then you will get answer 750 into 60 multiplication 0 0 0 then 6 zeros are 0, 6 5s are 30, 0 here 3 becomes carry, 6 7s are 42, 42 plus 3 45. So how much money they will get at the end of the day means they will get 45,000 at the end of the day. Okay, at the end of the day they will get 45,000 rupees. Now, first chapter has completed, Anna. Up to here. Today your homework is 6, 7, 8, 9. These top 4 problems are your homework. Complete your homework and send to me. Now, first chapter has completed. In our next video, we will discuss about second chapter. Up to here, complete and send to me. Okay, children? Very good.